Welcome back to stage two of this advanced demo series, where you're going to be provisioning private connectivity between the simulated on-premises environment on the left and the AWS environment on the right. Now, in production, you'd be using a VPN or Direct Connect, but to simulate that in this advanced demo series, you're going to be configuring a VPC peering connection. So you'll be configuring the connection between the on-premises and AWS environment, and then this will allow us to connect over this secure connection between these two VPCs. So to get started on that, we'll need to be at the AWS console, so let's switch over and get started. Now, to configure a VPC peering connection, we need to be in the VPC section of the console. So you can get to that by clicking on Services, typing VPC, and then clicking to move to the VPC console. So once we're at this console, I want you to open your VPCs, because these are the VPCs that will be creating the peer between AWS, which uses 10.16.0.0/16, and then the on-premises VPC, which uses the CIDR range of 192.168.10.0/24. So I'll leave this open in a tab because we'll be referencing it later. What I want you to do now is to scroll down on the menu on the left, locate peering connections, and then open that in a new tab. And then go ahead and click on Create Peering Connection. Now, when you're creating a peering connection, it's a relationship between two VPCs, the Requester VPC and the Acceptor VPC. First, go ahead and enter A4L-on-premises-2-AWS in the peering connection name tag. Then under VPC Requester, we need to set one half of this peering relationship. So click in the dropdown and select On-Prem VPC. So this is the left-hand side of the architecture you've seen previously, and the CIDR range for this is 192.168.10.0/24. Next, we need to set the acceptor half of this relationship. So this is the other component of the peer. So click in this dropdown and then select AWS VPC. This has a CIDR range of 10.16.0.0/16. Now, once you've got both of these selected, you can go ahead and scroll down and click Create Peering Connection. Now, if you're creating these VPC peers in separate AWS accounts, then one account would need to create the request and the other account would need to accept it. Because we're creating both of these in the same account, then you can do both of these processes. So to accept the request, make sure that you've got the peering connection selected and click on Actions and then Accept Request. Once you've done that, just go ahead and click on Accept Request to create the VPC peering connection. And that's the first part of this process completed. So now you've got the peering connection between the two VPCs, which creates a secure channel and a gateway object in both VPCs. The next step is we need to configure routing. We need to configure the VPC routers in each VPC to know how to send traffic to the other side of the VPC peer. So to do this, go ahead and click on Route Tables. We're going to start by editing the on-prem public route table, and we need to configure this so that the on-premises simulated environment knows how to route through to the AWS environment. So select this route table, so on-prem public RT. Then you'll need to click on the Routes tab, and then we'll need to add a route. So go ahead and click on Edit Routes, and then click on Add Route. And now we'll need the IP CIDR of the AWS environment. So go back to the previous tab that you have open, look for AWS VPC, and we need the IP version 4 CIDR of this VPC, which is 10.16.0.0/16. So go ahead and enter that in this box. So 10.16.0.0/16. Now, the target for this will be the VPC peer. So I'll need you to go ahead and click in the target dropdown and click peering connection. It should automatically populate this with the peering connection between these two VPCs. It should say A4L on-premises to AWS. So click on that. And once you've set that, this will mean that the on-premises environment knows how to route traffic through to the AWS environment. So now that you've done that, go ahead and click on Save Changes. And that's one side of this pairing relationship configured. Next, we need to edit both of the AWS route tables. Now, AWS has two route tables, the private route table and the public route table. We'll edit the public route table first, so select AWS Public RT. Then you'll need to click on the Routes tab, Edit Routes. Again, click on Add Route. This time we'll need the on-premises CIDR range, which is 192.168.10.0/24. So we'll need to enter that in the destination box of that route. So go ahead and enter 192.168.10.0/24. And then in the target box, again, we'll be picking the VPC peer. So click in the target dropdown, select Peering Connections, and then click on A4L on-premises to AWS.
So now that you've done that, go ahead and click on Save Changes.
Next, we'll do the private route table for AWS. So select AWS Private RT. Then you'll need to click on the Routes tab, Edit Routes, again, Add Route, and enter the CIDR range for the on-premises simulated environment. So 192.168.10.0/24, click on Target, select Peering Connections, and pick the peering connection again.
Go ahead and click on Save Changes.
And that's the routing configured at both sides of this VPC peer. So now we have the secure connection between the simulated on-premises environment and the AWS environment. We have gateway objects configured in both of the VPCs, and then routes configured at both sides so that they can communicate. Now, at this point, you've done everything required in stage two of this demo series. So go ahead, complete the video, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in stage three.